pray for all the young women that are seeking out their Boaz, or they're seeking out that God-fearing man that they have been waiting for as they've tarried and waited upon the Lord. Now, obviously, you know, as with every young lady that desires to get married, you know, sometimes we can come across different advice. Some people may say, stop wanting marriage and it will come to you. Or something like, ask God for your Boaz. Don't forget the gift of singleness, etc., etc. But when we look at the scripture, the Bible also tells us that David said, delight yourself in the Lord and he will give you the desires of your heart. Paul also said, if you're burning with passion or lust, it's best for you to get married. And Ruth didn't pray for a Boaz. She met Boaz out working, trying to survive and trying to, what, to honor her mother-in-law. So every single Christian woman is not going to be a Ruth. Some may be Deborah's, some may be Lydia's, some may be Hannah's. But we must understand that each person is going to be different to the next. But most importantly, we can learn something very, very important. And the Bible teaches us that in the book of Matthew 6, verse 33, it says, seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and everything else shall be added unto you. Hallelujah. So we have a prayer here, and we also, well, we have a scripture, we have Jesus' words speaking, saying basically, if you put his business first, then everything else shall be added unto you. It doesn't mean that you can't desire those things. It can't mean that the person that you are believing God is sending you is the person that you have right now. But it's most important that we seek God in that secret place to make sure that he is the one that is guiding those people into our lives. And while we're waiting on those people to come, we must also believe that it's an opportunity for us to change, for us to come closer to the Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. So as we start to get to those things, we also see the Bible says that Philippians 4, 6 and 7, it says, be anxious for nothing, but in all things through prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God, that the peace of God that surpasses all understanding will guard your hearts and your mind in Christ Jesus. So the key is asking from a humble heart. Whenever you come to God, supplication means asking God for something very humbly. So are you asking God humbly for that husband? And also with thanksgiving. So we know that it can be hard to give thanks in the midst of doubt, fear, broken relationships, disappointment, and so on and so on. But you may feel thankful that when you're hurt or angry and frustrated, you may not feel thankful, but the truth is, thankful, we don't have to feel it. We don't have to say it. The verse just says, give thanks. So when I am anxious, that is the time that we most need this verse. We say, thank you. Always starts as an act of will. So when you say thank you, it starts from your act of will. And often we've prayed for the grace to do that, to have that will, to have that. But obedience has the benefits of producing good fruit. Seek first his kingdom. That is the key. And maybe you've cried out and you've said, oh, but we've prayed. And the more I did that, the more I submitted my unmet longings to God. But maybe you felt the pain that led to pray, and those things haven't really been answered according to your perfect timing. But you know, God has appointed a time. He's appointed a perfect time. So maybe you're asking God for all these things, but maybe it's also an opportunity for God to what? To change you, to become more in his likeness. Hallelujah. Because there's always great work done, for none of us are perfect. We all stumble in many ways. But in that period of time, as you're praying and asking God to give that person to you, ask God first to change you. Ask him to change your heart. Maybe your heart hasn't been too good before the Lord, but God wants to change you. He wants to give you the best thing that you can do is wait upon the Lord. It is good to pray for a future husband, but we must do it in God's perfect way and in God's perfect timing. So if you're single and desire marriage, then prayer for your future husband is a must. And if you're not sure what to pray, then I encourage you to keep on listening. So in even with these prayers, that they may encourage you to seek God in His Word. Hallelujah. So we're just going to look at some areas that will help in seeking a future husband. So pray that God keeps your future husband from counterfeits, especially counterfeits that looks good to him. You know, you've got to be careful because counterfeits come, and so men don't trust their ability to distinguish between counterfeit and the real thing. That's something you got to pray for. You got to pray specifically. So ladies, men are moved so often by what they see, but not that, obviously women aren't, but men in particular are like this. So pray that he's able to distinguish between you, the real thing, and someone that's a counterfeit. Okay, another one. Pray that your future husband is open to God's leading. That's right, because your future husband may not have an especially strong relationship with God when you meet him. Whether or not you need someone exactly where you are spiritually is discussed and is important, I personally believe. But maybe when you first meet him, he may not be. But remember, when that person is strong in prayer, then he's going to be able to lead your family in the future. So by the time it comes to that point of marriage, it's important when he's stronger in prayer, it's going to encourage you to go stronger in the Lord. So pray for God that he opens, that he's open to God's leading in his life and those things concerning you. And also pray that God is developing your future husband's character and his heart. See, you know, as we've always said, character is better than gifts. Make sure that you have someone with a strong character. So often we get caught in the externals. We can get picky over how maybe the man looks or the woman looks, the kind of job he has, the kind of clothes he wears, the car he drives, etc. So most of us as human beings, we get caught that way. But specifically for women looking for a man, you must be very, very cautious about what you pick. So that's, you want the same thing for men. So as a result, we miss the true condition of the man's heart and character. A man with a good heart can easily buy new clothes if they're outdated, but only God can change a man's heart. So don't be put off by those things. John 14, verse 13 and 14 says that we can ask for anything in Jesus' name, and he will do it to glorify the Father. So you'll never know the possibilities in store for you unless you pray for your future husband and pray over him in such a way that your request is for God's glory, not for your own glory. So identify what's in your heart concerning your future husband and keep praying. Keep praying and ask God to speak directly to you and give you a fresh understanding of what it means to be married, what it means to go through a courtship, what it means to go through an engagement in his way and in his timing. Many of us want to jump ahead and date and do all these things, but I can tell you, dating is not the key. Praying is the key. Praying and asking God to change you is the key. So while you're waiting for God to bring your husband, you're also allowing God to change you and bring your character. So we're going to pray right now. So Lord, we pray right now in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Lord, we ask for whoever their future husband will be. Lord, we pray, but they may not know them, but you do, Lord Jesus. So we pray, Lord, as they continue to trust and put their life in your hands, and also believing that you will turn around things for your glory. Lord, we pray, Lord, that we lift up their future husband up to you this very day, Lord, and we pray that you would be with them. Even their future husband, you'll be with them and you develop them, lead them, guide them. Lord, we pray, Lord, that you will give them, Lord, I pray their husband, their future husband, a good day also, lead them into the paths of righteousness. Help them to enjoy, Lord, their friends and their family, that they may understand the importance of those things in life. Give them peace and restore them from maybe a hard day's work. Lord, we pray, Lord, that they will keep their eyes on you, that they will be able to encounter your presence in a whole new way. Lord, we pray, Lord, that you would prepare that partner for them and allow them to make the right choices and decisions, especially those things that are coming as they prepare for the weekend, as they prepare for the different things in life. Lord, we pray, Lord, that you'll help them, Lord, to be a light and a shining example for their friends and also for their families. Lord, whatever they are doing, let it be a reflection of your love for you, and may it bring glory to you. Lord, we pray this in your mighty name, and we give honor today that you will prepare this future husband of honor. Lord, please give their future partner today. Give them gifts. Lord, give them those gifts that they need, that they will bring glory, bring mentors and companions that will spur them on the pursuit of godliness, especially in the area of God-fearing men. We pray especially, Lord, that they would be an examples of godly men to look up to, that you will lead to that future husband of theirs. And we pray right now, Lord, that you will just surround them with people that will draw them nearer to you, Father, and not further away. And Lord, we pray that you will give them friends, friends that will bring laughter and joy and will also draw them closer to you. Dear Father, please give their future husband vision and clarity today. Lord, we pray, Lord, that you would inspire their future husbands with a strong vision for their life. Lord, I pray that only you know exactly what is in store for that person and precisely what timing it is for that person. But Lord, we pray that you would please remind them today of the vision that you gave them in the earlier time. Lord, I pray, Lord, that you would solely come and strengthen them and move them forward with confidence today. Lord, help them to love you more and everything else running after you. Lord, we thank you, Lord, that in the name of Jesus Christ, Lord, that you would fill them with your passion and your selfless, unashamed boldness, that they may proclaim you in their lives also. Dear God, please help their future husbands to be hard workers, that they may work to bring glory to your name. Help them to be honest in business and everyday life too. Lord, no matter how big or small or anything is, each and every day, even right now, help them to make wise choices to bring honor to you. Help them to have integrity and to stand up for what is right. Let their yes be yes and their no be no. Lord, we pray, Lord, that their future husband would learn also from day-to-day experiences and through the trials to be good leaders, that they may be able to lead their family in the future. We pray, Lord, that he would learn the qualities needed to make a great leader for his family and wife today. May he learn integrity, strength of mind, and above all, love. May he learn to be strong in his beliefs and not back down or give into the ways of this world. Lord, we pray that you will prepare him to be a leader, because all leaders requires boldness and humility and strength, but lowliness of heart, wisdom beyond his years. Give it to him, Lord, but also give him a meek spirit. We pray, Lord, that he may also learn your ways and become the leader for their new family, Lord, to be. We pray, Lord, that you will bless his day. You will bless him with peace and joy. Lord, may he be filled with your Holy Spirit and walk in truth and grace. Thank you for him, Jesus, that you're preparing for this dear daughter of Christ. Lord, we pray that you would bless the future husband as he seeks out the answers to questions that arise in this life. Lord, help him to know that as the author of all things, that you have all the answers. And Lord, help this future husband of this dear daughter of Zion, Lord, not to be afraid of what the answers might be as he seeks the truth in your word. Teach him to pursue truth with zeal. But at the same time, Lord, let him accept the things that he cannot find answers to, that he may also pursue you more until he receives those answers. Lord, we thank you, Lord Jesus. Lord God, we pray that you would also pray for the future husband. We believe today that he would love your word, the Bible, more. Help him to study and learn it from it every day. Guide him and give him wisdom when he reads, so that he will be able to teach and guide, Lord, his future family someday. Help him to meditate on the word day and night. Help him to allow it to prosper in all of his ways. Give him the ears to hear, that he may hear the word. Please give, Lord, him that future husband, or that daughter of Zion, the future husband, Lord, that will give that future husband the strength to face every temptation the world would lay constantly before him. Help him in his battles and struggles, and please let him know that you're beside him all the time, Father. I thank you, Lord, that you've sent your Holy Spirit to help him to grow stronger in every day. Please grant him wisdom in these decisions in life, especially right now that pertain to his future. Lord, please let him have a wonderful day, even this day, as we're praying on behalf of that future husband. Lord, we pray today, let him find rest and peace, Lord, as he hears your word today. Lord, we pray that he would love his family and want to have his own family when he marries on that particular day. We pray that he would have a loving heart towards children, and he is soft, gentle, and caring. Teach him the abilities that make a great father. Help him to learn how and what it needs to be a father and to be an amazing one. Give him amazing leadership skills and a heart to serve his family. Let him recognize the importance of this role and help him to embrace the call to be this father. Lord, we pray today for this future husband. Give him the humility to ask for help when it is need. Teach him to turn to help when he needs it, rather than trying to face his problems on his own. Lord, when he is fighting sins, as we know he will, please show him that in the end, asking for help is worth the monetary humiliation if it means overcoming this very vice. Lord, we pray today for this future husband of this dear daughter of Zion. Lord, that he'll be a good leader in whatever position that you may have him in now and in the future. Lord, we pray for his future home, his work, his church, and may his life and the things that he does be about bringing glory and honor to you. And may the other people around him see through him and want to come to know him, especially in the home as leading this farmer. Lord, we pray, Lord, for the gift of joy and happiness that you would give to him today. Let his heart be light and carefree today. Lord, don't let the troubles of this life and the worries of this world, Lord, distract him today. But let his laugh be heard and smiles be seen. Lord, as he comes to you and he's anxious for nothing, but in all things through prayer and supplication, he's making his request be made known to you. Lord, bless him today, whatever he's doing. Lord, whatever this future husband is doing for this daughter of Zion, bless him, be with him, and prepare him as they surrender everything into your hands, all desires and everything, knowing seeking first your kingdom and your righteousness is the key to this marriage and to this future partner coming. We thank you and we give you all the praise in Jesus' mighty name. This is Pastor Robert Clancy from Narrow Path Ministries.